When we analyze the commonality of successful organizations, private or public ones, we realize that all of them provide an exceptional customer experience. Leading companies know that putting customers in the heart of everything they do plays a critical role in improving overall performance. At the same time, our world is changing rapidly, and so does the customer expectation, especially when it comes to customer service. Customers do not longer compare us directly to the competition, but instead to the best service they receive from the favorite company or brand. Today in 2022, customers are more likely to solve an issue by calling the company directly and talking to a live customer service agent versus using self-service options compared to 2021. At the same time, 59% of the customers do also share that they believe customer service is worse than before the pandemic. Today I'm joined by Shep Hyken, customer service expert, futurist, and best-selling author. Shep, thank you so much for joining me.
It's great to be back. Thanks for having me.
Shep, based on your experience and the trends we are seeing in the market, how do you believe that the pandemic accelerates the need for technology? And how do you believe that the pandemic also impacts the expectations of customers, especially when it comes to omnichannel experiences and also the preferred channel and times?
Sure. That is a great question. And I think you used a great word in that question. That word was accelerate. So I don't believe much was invented during the pandemic. And if you go back just 2 years ago, when we were all put into this lockdown phase, and you asked me what customer service would look like 5 years from now, I would say it's exactly what we're experiencing today. The technology was always there. For example, the Microsoft CX platform wasn't invented just yesterday. It's evolved, and the existing applications have been adopted and adapted to meet the needs of not just the company, but also the customers. So the biggest change is really in the agent experience. They now have better tools that make it easier for them to give a better experience to the customer. So again, I believe the technology and the use of it was there, but it was accelerated. So essentially I say, hey, look into the future, it's happening right now. Now, as far as customer expectations, I believe they're higher than they've ever been. And that's because some companies are doing it just so well that they're creating this high bar for other companies to aspire to do as well. And the customers expect that that's going to happen. And I think that's a real important key, is to understand that expectations are that they no longer compare you to a direct competitor. Your customers are comparing you to the best experience they've had anywhere. Now, you also asked about channel preferences, as far as, is it the phone? Do they like to text? Do they mind using a digital channel and going online to get information or dealing with a chatbot? I believe today the customer doesn't think about channels. They think about what's easy for them. They pick up their phone, or if they're in front of their computer at work, they may be working on a desktop. They may decide to text you. They may be in your app. It's whatever channel is easiest for the customer. That's what they want to use.
Shep, I actually read very interesting outcomes in your recent study, like 50% of the customers think that when calling customer support for a problem, an issue or a question, the company does not value their time. Or another example, 46% of customers would rather go to the dentist than call the customer support. Where do you believe this is coming from, and what can organizations do to deliver a true omnichannel experience and prove they are respecting the time of their customers while improving convenience and friction?
Yeah. By the way, that last stat, 46% of customers would rather go to the dentist than call customer support. I threw a few of those fun questions in because I think they kind of illustrate sometimes the pain that customers experience. And part of it is they don't remember all the great experiences, but when there's a bad experience, it's like the squeaky wheel, and that's what gets the oil. So what happens is a customer calls, they're put on hold for a long period of time without the option of a callback. Perhaps they finally get somebody, and then that agent doesn't have the answer. They send you to somebody else. You have to repeat your story. Then you're disconnected and you have to call back. And people go, oh, I'd rather go to the dentist than call customer support. Well, hopefully that's not the case with the people that are watching this interview. But let's talk about this for a moment. It's all, you know, and this is the point. We asked the consumers, do you feel that companies value your time? And that number is pretty big. Many of them said, no, they don't. And that's because they're wanting to get their information quickly, but they're not. So it's all about how much time it takes to get the information, how much time it takes to get a question answered or a problem resolved. Time is important and convenience is important. Wasting time is actually friction, and customers hate friction. For example, how long are your wait times? Now, here's a question we asked, and we found that a really incredible stat that 87% of your customers are willing to wait up to 5 minutes for a help response before they become frustrated with the hold time. And if it's email, 71% are willing to wait an hour. And I think that that's important understanding so that we can create a basic standard that we want to provide our customers. We obviously can never make 100% of the people happy all of the time. As a matter of fact, there was a small percentage, 6% said, I don't want to wait at all. Okay, well, that's impossible. You make a phone call, you're going to be put on hold, even if it's only for 15 or 20 seconds. Anyway, when we work with companies, we ask what the response times are, and we hope to set a standard that will allow them to create a better experience for the customers. So while they may not, if they call and they're asked to be put on hold, we need to give them the option. Do you want to stay on hold or do you want us to call you back? And while they may not get the answer they need right away, at least they won't have to wait and feel like we're wasting their time in the process of getting their information.
These are amazing insights, Shep. And based on the trends you are seeing today, what can organizations expect to happen in the next 5-10 years, right? And what can they do today? What are the key considerations they need to take today in order to be prepared and in order also to secure growth and profitability?
Sure, that's a great question. We actually surveyed over 1,000 consumers and we asked them, what do you think is going to happen in the next 5 years? Or what would they like to see happen? And the number one answer was, we want 24/7 availability. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean your agents are on call 24/7, but we've got to give them at least digital experiences that will allow them to get basic information and answers quickly. And that comes in the form of online chat, which actually was the number two requested, you know, experience that they have in the next 5 years. So they expect there to be online chat, which means, and this is great, agents can typically work with 2, 3, and sometimes even more customers, depending on the type of information they're sharing, in an online chat environment. Our customers expect us to be able to complete all customer service interactions. Are you ready for this? On a mobile device. The phone is even more important than ever. They want a personalized experience. They want you to be able, they want them to think that you know who we are as customers. Intuitive self-service options, that's very important. Never being put on hold was something that they expect will happen in the future. In other words, we'll never be wasting their time. They do want human interactions, but it's obvious that it will be perhaps a digital first experience. Human is a backup when needed. And finally, and this is a big one, artificial intelligence and machine learning is going to be able to answer customers' questions in a way that makes it easier, more comfortable, more streamlined, and is a great experience overall.
That's a great point, Shep, because I actually wanted to ask you about this. How important is machine learning and artificial intelligence when it comes to organizations really looking into automating processes, right? And improving, of course, the customer experience and the own resources they have.
Yeah, so, you know, the whole idea behind AI and machine learning, at first, companies were saying, let's use artificial intelligence to have a chat bot that's going to answer customers' questions. So they're still not interacting with agents. But I believe if you use machine learning the right way and AI, you can get data and information that'll actually support the agent and allow them to create a better experience for the customer. For example, that machine learning and artificial intelligence can tell the agent, this is who this customer is that you're talking to. This customer has bought this in the past. They've called about this in the past. We know who this customer is. Now you know who this customer is. And by the way, this customer is the same as 5,000 other customers that we have. Exactly the same. We know what question this customer is going to ask before they even ask it.
Yeah.
That's a powerful place to be. So we can make recommendations, which allows us to personalize the experience. So AI and machine learning, it's not just to create data and information and ultimately AI support a chatbot for the customer. How about it supports the agent, which gives them the ability to be empowered to take care of that customer at a level that they've never been able to do before.
Talking about agents, Shep, what do you believe or how important is the link between agent or employee empowerment and customer experience, right? I've seen a lot of articles around the impact, the link between both worlds and how important and crucial it is to merge these worlds together. What is your view on this, please?
Well, here's the thing. If I'm a customer and I call a company, I am hoping that I am going to be talking to the person that will be able to take care of me. I don't want to have to go through my story, get switched from one person to the next person to the next person. It shouldn't be escalated. Here's a really cool thing that machine learning allows us to do. It will recognize the phone number of the customer calling in, or it'll recognize the customer through whatever channel they're coming in on. It will route that customer to the appropriate department, appropriate person, whoever is best capable to handle that customer. If it's a VIP customer, maybe they go to one place. If this customer has a specific product that they bought in the past, they may get routed to somebody else that's an expert. We have great opportunity to get the customer to the right people through machine learning. And when we use this technology properly, it will empower that agent to best take care of the customer. The other thing is we've got to create an environment that allows that to happen. So, and I know I'm going to be getting away from technology on this answer, but here's the point. Leadership and the company culture has to allow the front line to be able to deliver what needs to be done without having to constantly going back and ask permission every single time they feel like, well, this is a little bit outside of what typical protocol is. So we need to establish with agents what they are allowed to do. Then we need to let them do it. And if the agent doesn't know what to do and they go back and ask their supervisor, manager, their leader, hey, how do I do this? And they're taught to do it or they're given permission to do something, that's the only time they should ever have to ask. Because once we allow it for this customer, it should be training that we can do this for any customer. By the way, if it's a one-off situation and the manager says you can do this one time, I get it. But generally, the questions that are asked are the types of things that allow agents to learn what they're capable of doing and allows the management to empower them now to go do it again and again and again as necessary. So I know that gets away from technology, but that's just what we have to let our people do. If we want to create the ultimate customer experience, that customer, when they call in, needs to feel they're talking with somebody that has the capability and the confidence and the permission to take care of them the way they need to be taken care of.
Absolutely. I 100% agree with you, Shep, and I believe it will be more and more of top priority for organizations to look into how they empower their teams, not only when it comes to access to the right data and insights, right, but also from a cultural perspective. So 100% agree with this one. Shep, you have worked with many organizations across many different industries. What is, from your perspective, the commonality of organizations who are really able to deliver an exceptional customer experience across different channels?
So I'm going to use one word, easy. That's what it's all about. The rock star companies that are out there are making it easy for the customer to do business with them. They have automated processes, great self-service solutions, digital tools. They make it easy to find contact information as far as who to reach, easy to connect with a live agent whenever it's needed. That's the bottom line. And in short, here's what it is. I'm going to go back to a word that I believe we used earlier in our conversation, and that is convenience. There's low or no friction. Customers love convenience. That's one of the big drivers of a competitive differentiator, is how easy and convenient you are to do business. And by the way, this not only applies to customers on the outside, but internally, if you want your agents to feel great about where they work and really, you have to make it easy for the agent as well to deliver to their customers. So internally, we need to give a great agent experience, because what's happening on the inside is being felt on the outside by our customers.
Absolutely, Shep. And when thinking about really simplifying processes, right, and creating some sort of convenience and reduce friction, how can technology help customers or organizations to improve the customer experience internally, but also externally?
Sure. And we've talked a little bit about this already. So kind of a recap. Number one, we want to make it easy for customers to get to us. We want to respect their time. We want to cut down on the friction. At the same time, what does technology do? It allows customers to come in on different channels. And ideally, if a customer has a simple question and they get, say, to a chatbot, that chatbot is intuitive. It understands what the customer wants, gives them the information, but it also understands if they are not able, you know, the machine knows, we're not able to give that customer what they want, seamlessly transferring them to a live agent. It seems natural. You don't even know. The customer doesn't have to repeat their story. Technology will allow, and if you get people to go digital first, technology will allow that customer to get answers or be seamlessly moved to a human. And when they do get moved, there's no lag time. In other words, there's no long waits, ideally. They get right on with the agent who's informed and empowered to take care of them. To me, that's the great experience. Customer approaches you on any channel they want, whatever's most convenient to them. Ideally, and in the future, we're going to see this, they're going to probably go digital first for the most part. By the way, our study shows that the older the customer is, the more likely they are to want to go with the traditional phone. But over time, that is going to change. As a major base of customers is starting, you know, young, they're going to be growing up and getting older. This is what's going to be the way of doing business. Digital first with the backbone of a human to human interaction. And when we do it right, the customer is going to love us. They're going to say they're easy to do business with. This is what we want. We want the word always in front of something positive. They're always so easy. They're always so knowledgeable. They're always so helpful. Those words always followed by something positive lets you know that you're creating that amazing experience that you want your customers to have.
Absolutely, Shep. Shep, I really want to thank you for your time today and for sharing your valuable insights and also some outcomes of your most recent study with us. Really looking forward to connect with you very soon again, and take care.
Well, thank you very much. I can't wait. And as I always love our customers to say, I'll say it myself, I'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, today you got an outlook on the future of customer service and on the value technology, machine learning, and AI can bring to your business. We also learned about how the pandemic has accelerated technology trends across all industries, while customer expectations are rising and customer satisfaction is harder to achieve in times where customers have more voice and more power than ever, especially with the expansion of social media, chat, and other digital channels. I truly believe it's an absolute exciting time to leverage this as an opportunity for your organization and to secure future growth and profitability. In order for organizations to leverage this as an opportunity, they have to listen to their employees and empower the employees with a flexible working culture, but also with the technology that makes their life easier when it comes to user experience, when it comes to the right access to data and insights. Those teams need to be empowered with the right tools at the right time to guide and collaborate with customers remotely. With the right technology, we can enable them to drive meaningful action and maximize engagement while focusing on what matters most, them customers. If you want to learn how Microsoft can empower your organization to deliver a true omnichannel experience and provide a seamless end-to-end customer service experience within a single solution to deliver consistent, connected support across channels and to earn customers for life, please visit the Microsoft D365 customer service page or reach out to me. Thank you so much.